29-year-old in her first Olympic Winter Games. She has World Cup wins, but they're in downhill. She has 3 World Cup podiums in Super-G, 3rd in Lake Louise and Val d'Isère in December of 2021. Time can be gained in this canyon section. We've seen it throughout these Olympic Winter Games. There's up to half a second to be found if you can get your gliding skills right. 1:13.94. She's inside. Oh. Ledecká won't defend her title. Pukna moves into the gold medal position. She finds 32 hundredths in the canyon. Already an Olympic medalist and a world championship medalist in disciplines such as alpine combined and giant slalom. What can she do with the speed skis on? 0.65 of a second. She secured her second Super-G podium in Cortina, January 2022, when she was third. And Gizin has had a sensational bottom section. 1:13.73. Gizin is outside by 0.08 of a second. But she loses time in the canyon. Wins in this discipline, including one this season in St. Moritz, and then the following day had a spectacular crash which she walked away from, but already 13 hundredths down on Miriam Pukna, our leader.
Look at how nice and dynamic she's getting with the lower body as she's still keeping those shoulders low in that nice tuck position, the hands right out front, nice and tight, trying to get as much speed as she can across this upper section.
Switzerland have never won a Super-G in either the men's or the women's at the Olympic Winter Games. 0.67 of a second to work with, but we've seen time won and lost in this section. At least 0.67 won and lost in this section. So this isn't a sure thing for Gupparami. 1:13.73, but she's in by 0.22. Lara Gupparami of Switzerland leads the women's Super-G.
Yeah, and she knows it's close. Is that going to be enough?